Chapter 1. What is a drug substance? Imagine reading this headline in the news. New cancer drug approved. Upon further reading, you discover that the new drug is a biologic. You may wonder what a biologic is and how a new one is even made in the first place. Before we discuss how new biologic drugs are made, we must first consider a common component that is found in all medicines, a drug substance. A drug substance is an active ingredient of a medicine that causes the desired therapeutic effect. It can be a simple small chemical molecule, a large protein molecule, also called a biologic, or a complex molecule containing both of these components. A medicine can contain one or more of these drug substances to cure, mitigate, or lessen, treat, prevent, or diagnose a disease, or to affect the structure or function of a specific target in the body. A drug substance is carried into the body by a drug product. A drug product is a dosage form such as tablet, capsule, syrup, or solution. Now that we know what a drug substance is, let's find out how one is made. Chapter 2. What is process development? Drug development is a multi-step process. The early phase of development is dedicated to identifying the lead or the ideal drug candidate out of a pool of many candidates. Once the lead candidate has been identified, the development process is divided into two parallel pathways. One of these pathways is called process development. As its name implies, this pathway involves the development of a process for making the drug candidate on a large scale. Process development can be further divided into two broad categories. The first category is called drug substance process development. Drug substance process development is extensive and typically involves performing a number of experiments to establish the process for making a drug substance on a large scale. The second category is called drug product process development. This is where the drug substance is formulated into a final marketable product that will be used by patients. The second pathway, which follows the early phase, is known as clinical development. In this pathway, the drug candidate is evaluated for its safety and efficacy and how it is metabolized in the body. Once process development and clinical development have been completed, a drug candidate can move on to the last step. This final step involves gathering all the data about various processes and the safety and efficacy of the drug candidate. This information is compiled and ultimately submitted to a regulatory body for approval. Chapter 3. Drug substance process development. Now that we have outlined the drug development process, let's focus on the components of drug substance process development that will be featured in this pathway. In particular, we'll take a closer look at how drug substance process development is carried out ahead of manufacturing of a biologic. Biologics are generally produced in living cells that have been adapted to grow in a controlled environment outside of a living body. To begin, we will learn how the cells are grown in the lab. We will then explore the molecular techniques and cellular attributes that must be considered to express and produce biologics in cells. We will also learn how one particular cell for making a biologic is identified from a large pool and then cloned. We will then find out why it is necessary for manufacturers to do this to produce biologics on a large scale. Up until this stage, process development is exploratory in nature and is done on a smaller scale. But the goal of drug substance process development is to produce biologics on a very large scale to treat patients. In the next step, the process involves larger, tightly controlled vessels called bioreactors. At this point, all the parameters for optimal cell growth are strictly monitored and controlled. To learn more about this, we will investigate how bioreactors work as well as the process controls in bioreactors. These process controls are important to maintain the same conditions each time we make a batch of the biologic. This ensures that we yield consistent results in terms of productivity and drug product quality. Lastly, we will learn how the biologic is obtained in its purest form through a process known as purification. Purification is a multi-step process that aims to remove different types of impurities at each step. At the end of this process, the drug substance is ready to be made in a desired dosage form. Chapter 4. Conclusion. To recap, process development for a drug substance is a critical part of the overall development process. It helps drug manufacturers to understand what challenges, if any, may arise when making a drug substance such as a biologic. This understanding then offers manufacturers troubleshooting opportunities before they transition to a large-scale manufacturing of the drug. Such troubleshooting during process development ultimately ensures the optimization of product quality, raw material and investment costs, and drug reliability.